Wood ash is a soil disinfectant to fight fungal and viral diseases of vegetables. Wood ash has the ability to absorb harmful substances and is a powerful detoxifier. Sprinkling with ash binds the toxins produced by plants and microorganisms. Using ash in the garden protects plants from diseases such as gray mold. Sprinkling rows of ashes between vegetables and fruits, e.g. under strawberry bushes, increases their yield as it is also a fertilizer, but also protects them against gray mold and pests. Ash also improves the soil structure, favors the development of microflora, especially nitrogen-fixing bacteria. Before sowing seeds, e.g. carrots, parsley, beetroot, and even potatoes, ash, a thin layer, is poured into the grooves, or the seeds themselves are mixed with the ash before sowing and then thrown into the groove. This treatment protects plants against fungal diseases and some pests, but also provides minerals. It is the simplest, the so-called seed treatment, i.e. protection against the harmful effects of pests and diseases. Treating with wood ash will be effective if you use ash from deciduous trees, except oak and bird cherry ash will be best, as it shows a high decontamination efficiency. It is used, for example, to prevent the development of powdery mildew in potatoes. Before sowing, the whole or cut potato tubers are sprinkled with ash, including potato ditches, which prevents the invasion of pests and disinfects the whole of pathogens causing gray mold, rot, mildew, and other vegetable diseases. You can also use ash as a plant protection measure against pests. In spring, we sprinkle it around the plants immediately after planting, for example, seedlings of cabbage, cauliflower, Brussels sprouts or kohlrabi. Sprinkle the soil thinly around each plant. If it rained heavily, repeat the sprinkling. You can also sprinkle young plants of onion and other vegetables with ash, preferably along the rows, to protect them from pests. The ash sprinkles along the rows of carrots to protect them from root fly. Dusting the leaves protects them from aphids. It is important to just sprinkle them and not to cover them with ashes or they will suffocate. It is worth adding some ash to e.g. clay pulp or compost tea, and then soak the roots of the plant in it to protect the seedlings from pests, facilitate their absorption and additionally stimulate growth in the first stage of development. If we want to root a shoot seedling in ordinary water, we can sprinkle it with a pinch of ash powder, which will inhibit the growth of harmful bacteria and accelerate the rooting of cuttings, and we can also add ash to the water in a vase with cut flowers, where it will work similarly to rooting cuttings. It is very useful if you grow vegetable seedlings at home, sprinkling it on the substrate, e.g. in a pot, will prevent the appearance of ugly white mold on the surface of the ground, and the substrate stained with ash will also become less attractive for Sciuridae, dark-winged fungus gnats. Ash prevents the development of mold fungi, thanks to which we can protect plants against many diseases. Moving back to the Victorian times, according to local recipes, ash was used to sprinkle rose bushes, which was to prevent fungal diseases. Perhaps it is the sulfur content of the ash that inhibits the growth of fungal pathogens. Calcium deficiency causes inhibition of plant growth, the appearance of dry rot on the tops of tomatoes and peppers, or bitter spots on apples. The leaves are deformed and their tips dry up. By using wood ash as a fertilizer, we can prevent such calcium deficiencies. It should be taken into account that the pH of the ash is from 9 to 13, so we use it carefully with acid-loving plants and soils where it should be acidic. Due to its high pH, it can be used for soil deacidification, similarly to fertilizer lime. The optimal dose of ash is about 30 to 50 grams of ash per 1 square meter of neutral soil. This dose will simultaneously deacidify the soil, or from 50 to 100 grams per 1 square meter in acidic soils. The ash can be dug with the soil to a depth of 10 centimeters, sprinkled on top or made a water solution of the ash, e.g. 50 to 150 grams of ash per 10 liters of water, and water the soil with it. Smaller doses do not significantly affect the soil pH and nutrient content. Wood ash acts as a kind of purifying filters, removes various toxins from the substrate, including pesticides, heavy metals, chlorine, and also reduces the growth of mold, bacteria, fungi, pathogens and soil pests, e.g. nematodes. In addition, it can also neutralize unpleasant odors. Remember to only use wood ash from raw wood. Hard coal ash is unsuitable due to the content of various toxic substances that are carcinogenic and harmful to humans if they penetrate into vegetables, and to the plants themselves, as well as when burning with garbage, waste paper, wood painted with varnishes and paints.